left but the prey.
Hey guys, Lord Naren White here, the Holy Ghost, the one true God. Back with you with the next video in my Witcher 3 playthrough. In today's video, continuing with Witcher 3. Alchemy. This is the Peller's Hut. Well, we could go a lot of different directions actually here in terms of progress. I say we head over here and then head to the Peller's Hut after we clear all this stuff out, like where we were at. So we'll go with that approach. Oh my god. Well, this bandit camp is absolutely massive.
Don't let him catch his breath. Oh, you witch fucker.
There's no lack of mobs here, that's for sure. Jesus, man.
You'll regret your mom ever squirting you out.
Oh man, that's a tough one, dude. You definitely can't get like enveloped by them. I'm gonna be in a bad state though. Really? Is this the last place I saved? Let's see an autosave. Maybe I loaded an autosave somewhere. Oh no, hold on. Wow. It sure looks like it. Jesus Christ. It sure looks like it. Oh man, that sucks. Alright, well. That's why you save frequently, you know? So, that's tough.
Take care now.
At least the one benefit is we were able to keep the sword, which is actually like pretty useful.
Fancy a gander?
Show me what you got.
So yeah, sorry about that. That you were seeing this twice. I'll be on my way. So yeah.
See ya.
Roach.
Could use some hair of the hound.
Well, here we go.
Let's dance.
Alright, so.
Come on, Roach.
Yeah, so this beach is crazy. There's so many mobs on this beach. We need to be careful. I think we should opt for a tawny owl because that will increase our... Actually, I think we should use both tawny owl and thunderbolt just to get them down as fast as possible. We haven't been enveloped, though. That's a good start, basically.
Don't let him catch his breath!
But we're sure not done yet. There are actually more of them here.
Kill if you love the gods! Drive me numbers to work!
Did we get everything? I think we did. I think we cleared out the whole freaking coast. Man, that was fun. So not too bad. Definitely teaches the importance of saving often. Unsent letter. Boss, we've looked and looked for that Queen Zulakea's treasure, and what have we found? Fuck, beg your pardon all. Though we have mighty enjoyed eating our fill of the oysters we fish off of the bottom. You sure that map's the real deal, boss? Not some counterfeit? Cause it seems to me that sailor cheated us, but we'll keep looking around till something eats us, or till you give us other orders. Oh, okay. So there does seem to be actually a treasure over here, so that's very interesting. We should probably head back over there. Is there something here? Here. Pirate's notes. Yesterday we found a silver basin and a ruby brooch on the bottom. Maybe means Queen Zulakea's treasure really is somewhere around here. Maybe in the hold of one of the wrecked ships off the west coast. But we can't check them at the moment. Waves are too high. We'll have to wait till the sea's calm. We're a pitching camp. Look at those drowners, bro. Well done. Level 15 noon wraith. I don't think I can beat her, but I can try. No, I do not think I should fight this Naren White yet. At level 15, she's pretty powerful, so I'll really hold off on fighting her. Let's see if I can sneak around her and get the treasure. That would be kind of cool. Nope, not able to. Not worth trying to even attempt this fight right now, I would say. I was trying to call Roach and I was wondering what happened there for a second. It's alright. Oh, it doesn't even appear that there is actually something there. There just is a freaking level 15 Naren Wraith there for some reason. No idea why, but yeah. Anyways, let's head up here. Glad I saved. Definitely want to activate Tawny Owl probably in the beginning. And Thunderbolt actually isn't a bad idea also. Not a bad idea to probably activate both of them. Hey, nice. So obviously there's probably a key somewhere here, right? Probably on the leader, I think. He's somewhere back there. We'll figure it out. Thank you.
Bandit's notes.
Nilf bastards must have coin coming out of their asses. They buy every present I capture. No matter if he's lame, cross-eyed, or dumb as a rotten stump. Never haggle, neither. They need folk for the silver mine, they say. And no one ever lasts more than 2 months there anyway. So every hand helps. Fine by me. Business is good. Only thing worrying me is that soon I'll have caught all the peasants around, and then who'll sell? Who'll I sell? Wow. That is so evil. That's the key. We saw the key there. The bandit key, so that's very good. I don't know if I need to exit the game and reload or what to be able to talk to this guy, but that's what I'm going to try right now, actually. I'm going to quickly try to quit to the main menu and return. Ah, never mind. He seems to be heading off. Good enough. Okay, good enough for me. I'll continue on questing. That's where I'll go ahead and end the video there for this week. With that, I want to say thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Please like, comment, and subscribe, as it greatly helps the channel. Like to be with you all. Take care, and thanks again.